What's up mga kap? It's me, Kap Joey Pumakap, and we are here at Bedford, Nova Scotia, Pumakap. Samahan niyo akong alamin ang Kap story ng Tinapay dito sa Bedford, Nova Scotia. For giving me this chance na malaman again yung kwento natin dito sa Tinapay. Yeah. I think I still remember two years ago nung nag-open kayo, nandito kami, and ang bilis ng panahon, no? Parang yeah. Kailan lang. Oh,
parang kailan lang. Kaya ano, nag-anniversary kami, wow, 2 years na pala tayo.
2 years na, grabe. Nakaka-amaze yung inyong success kasi nakita natin yung significant ng growth ng iyong business. Diba? Daming awards! Ano yung mga awards na natin? Recently, you have community awards.
Yeah, community awards. So, from last year that we got actually seven awards, which is, yeah, from Community Votes Halifax, from different categories like pastry cakes, coffee, specialty coffee cafes.
Amazing.
So, it's very overwhelming.
As of now, yung consistent pa rin yung award.
Yeah, we got extra one.
Ngayon, 8 or 11.
Yeah, we didn't expect.
9 categories na.
Well,
that only shows na ang support ng community.
Absolutely.
Diba? Yes. So, kung nag-strive kami dahil sa kanila.
Absolutely.
And we keep doing what we do best dahil sa kanila.
Absolutely. And dito ko nasabi na, uy, may sobrang significant yung growth ng Tinapay because you can see the award and the people really love yung products and services. And I think, hindi lang tong products eh. And it's all about the community involvement nyo rin. Ang dami yung community involvement and people really love the product and the people behind Tinapay. Speaking of behind Tinapay, sino si Sandy, sino si Sharon, and saan nagsimula ang Tinapay?
So,
si Sharon.
So, nag-start kami dito sa Canada as a regular work permit handlers. So, nag-start kami in a restaurant. We're both working in the same restaurant. And then, as a side hustle, so sabi ko, because I used to bake a lot in the Philippines, but I don't have like an actual store through ordering then from house. So sabi ko, I want to continue here, pero I don't know where to start. Ano ba yung in demand or ano ba yung hinahanap ng tao? Since, yun nga, sabi ko, more on, I'm craving for Filipino baked goods back home. And nandito ako, why, sabi ko, I want, kasi mahilig ako nun sa ensaymada, but I cannot find like a good ensaymada here. Since kakastart lang natin, so sabi ko, try natin, maggawa ko na ensaymada. So nung nag-bake ako, nag-start ako mag-bake, then Sandy said, okay siya. Nag-develop ako ng recipe. Siya yung aking number one critic.
Si Sandy ang critic.
So,
and at the same time,
ayun. Nag-start doon, tapos start ako mag-bake, and then give it to people, start to introduce through word of mouth.
So, actually, nag-stimula yung tinapis sa trial lang. So, basketball community, Filipino community, events, then from there, nag-grow.
Yeah.
So, sino nga ba si Sharon? So, si Sharon, background niya is, we're both chefs.
Yes.
So, history namin from five-star hotel in Philippines, Caribbean work, then we got an opportunity to
immigrate.
Napunta kami sa Canada. Una akong napunta dito. Kasi nauna akong na-approve sa work permit dito. Then, through spousal program, kunawa ko si Sharon. Yun nga, so we both work sa same company, which is the Donald's Restaurant, sabihin ko na. And during our time, that restaurant got voted for Best Burger in Halifax for 10 consecutive some years. So, now, but may nakita kami opportunity sa baking passion ng asawa ko.
Yes.
So, and I'm here to support.
Absolutely.
So, naging ano namin, yun yan, simula kami sa community, word of mouth, nag-increase ang demand.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, ano lang yun, home-based setup lang kami.
Mm-hmm.
Despite of the pandemic hits.
Yeah.
Despite ng pandemic, the demand is still there.
Yes. Yeah.
So, umating sa point na hindi na namin kaya gawing home-based setup.
Yeah.
So, na hanap kami ng space.
Mm-hmm.
And during that time, maraming ano, maraming nagsasarado. Uh-huh. And sabi ng iba, are you guys crazy?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see, why are you open up?
Why you guys are opening samtalang kaya bumukas? Yun nga yung ironic kasi nga din. So, parang blessing in disguise. Despite the pandemic, mayroong mag-sprout.
Absolutely. So, may nagsasarami nagbubukas.
Andun yung fear.
Yeah.
But hindi kami nagpatalo sa takot. Kasi sabi ko, wala tayong umpisihan kung magpapatalo tayo sa takot.
Yeah. Yun yung isa sa mga struggle. So, alam natin na during that time, yung mga permitting, application, delay. Kasi lahat, home-based setup, tapos yung iba, walang pwedeng gumawa dahil nasa pandemic.
Mm.
So, natenga kami. Dumating yung point na pati equipment namin delayed, permitting delayed.
Yeah, almost.
So, nag-acquire kami ng space April.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine, nakapagbukas kami end of October.
Oh, end of October.
So, ano yung time na yon? So, yung time na yon, permitting, inspection, delayed lahat. So,
till nakapag-open na kami.
Pero hindi kami na wala ng ano kasi alam namin na we have a good product.
Yeah.
We have a good system.
Yes.
Alam experience. Namin.
Experience. Yes.
So, plus yung experience namin to handle those things. So, yes. Yun nga. We still believe sa kakayanan namin na pwede na, alam namin mag-survive kami kahit paano. Pero, yun nga.
Unti-unti lang.
Thank you pa rin kami dahil alam namin yung community support na kami.
Yes. So, and I think that this is something that I want you guys to learn from their journey is sabi nga, we start from the ground, nakita din natin yung flow, start from home base, and now you have a big business. It's not just big, it's growing business. And this is so inspiring for everyone, mga kabs natin nanonood right now. It's very inspiring kasi from home base into a big business, a growing business, and now nandito na tayo. And you will see also yung struggles, no? Nung pag-open ng store, hindi madali.
Hindi madali.
Hindi madali.
Not pero just financially,
yeah,
emotionally, hindi, physically.
Yes, lahat na, no? Pero I think umaapo yung passion, no? Umaapo yung passion ninyong dalawa in paggawa ng product na to. As I, people love, really love the product. I really love Sharon's product. Pero yung passion ninyo mas umaapo. That's why talagang decidido, ano? So, aside from the struggles, I know you mentioned mga struggles. Ano yung number one tip mo? Tip ninyo sa mga, sabihin na natin, may mga kaps tayo all over Canada, mga kababayan natin. They're also planning to start business. Yung experience, the struggle, sabi nga natin, may up and downs, iyak, may stress. What's your best tip for that?
A lot of stress.
Ako, best advice ko sa kanila, have a plan. So, ang plan nyo is ups and downs. So, pag napunta sa ganito, anong plan nyo? Pag napunta dito, anong plan nyo? So, you always have
ready
a backup plan.
Yeah.
Make a plan for those circumstances. So, plus, samahan nyo ng passion. Huwag nyo isipin nakikita kayo.
Yeah.
Yun yung number one na mali. Pag inisip nyo na gusto nyo tumayong kayo ng business dahil kikita kayo, you fail. Instantly. Kasi, hindi ganun. So, kailangan, para mag-strive yung business, you have to start somewhere. Kailangan ipakita nyo na kaya nyo to, kaya nyo i-sustain to, kaya nyo consistency nito. You always have to think about your customer first.
Mm-hmm.
Yun ang kailangan nyo intindihin. Pag intindihin nyo, gusto kong kumita, you're only thinking about yourself.
Kasi a lot
hindi
of
people... Hindi magsusustain yun.
Mm-hmm.
Pero paano mong isipin gusto mong kumita kung ayaw ng customer mo yung product mo? What will happen?
Yung yeah. Possible yung quality,
oh, diba?
Production. Yeah.
So kailangan isipin mo ano yung gusto ng market mo.
Yeah.
And from there, will flow. Mm-hmm. Yun ang best advice ko sa akin.
Absolutely.
Tsaka, yun nga, passion.
Passion.
kasi hindi ka magko-continue if you don't love what you're doing.
Absolutely.
Kasi every day, it's like a cycle lang. Every day, yan ang haharapin mo. Pero yung day na, every day na pagod, na susukuan mo, yun yung kailangan harapin mo. Pero pag sinabi mo, kaya mo to strive for one day, for another day, and for the rest, passion yun. Absolutely. Sabihin, hindi ka susuko. Kasi okay ka gusto ngayon, mo yung ginagawa mo.
Ngayon, yeah. Hindi ka ngayon. Kailangan hindi magpapago about your passion.
Absolutely.
Andun yung sabi mo nakakapagod, pero I'm still happy of what I'm doing.
Yes.
Kasi part na yun ng everyday living.
Lahat naman tayo napapagod, di ba? Yes. Kahit anong trabaho.
Kahit anong trabaho. It's
kahit
so tiring,
matulog lang yung nakakapagod.
Ang tawag nga nila doon is labor of love.
Yes.
Pag hindi mo ginawa yun, pag wala kang ganong love sa ano, hindi ka magsasustain.
Hindi din nila, hindi nararamdam ng customers din yun eh. Pag, yung, pag walang labor of love, di ba? Pag meron yun, ramdam na ramdam.
It will affect the product.
Absolutely.
Sometimes yun, mararamdaman mo, I don't feel like itong ginagawa ko. Parang mas okay yung kahapon, parang ngayon, yeah. I don't feel. Yung ibang ano, bakit parang iba yung things na ganito? Minsan ganun din yung tao.
Yeah.
Pero yun nga, mag-strive ka to do it better.
Yes.
Kung may mali, from previews, you have to fix it. The following day, fix it. And then go on.
Yes. And I just want to add also, no, yung sinabi ni Sharon talagang passion is the key talaga. Kasi minsan tayo lahat, no, I mean, kahit anong industry, nakakapagod naman.
Oh.
Diba? But if you're passionate, walang pagod. Kasi masaya ka sa ginagawa mo. And you think out of the box. That's amazing.
Yeah. And seeing people happy too, you know, having your products, trying your products, going back here, sasabihin nila, oh, I tried your...
Yung fuel.
Na every time I heard that feedback, ang saya. Kasi hindi lang ako gumagawa dahil gusto ko, pero may taong natutuwa because they love what we're doing.
Absolutely.
Yung mga Filipino product na item na, yung mga items natin na Filipino-inspired. So, hindi lang nalilimit sa mga cakes, sa mga baked goods, sa mga goodies, pati sa mga drinks natin. So we're not just cakes and bakery. So we also have a good selection ng mga drinks natin. So
gusto
natin ang scramble.
Yes. And so, I think this is something na nakaka-excite dito kasi I think sooner meron pa kayong mga ilalabas pang, di ba?
May
aabangan. May aabangan.
We're always evolving. So yes. It's parang ano, lagi nating pinipresent sa mga client natin, sa mga market natin na meron always something to look for.
Yes, may aabangan dito sa sinabi. Pero pinaka-best ko mga kap, if you're here in Nova Scotia, you're here in Halifax, you're a newcomer, visit, sinabi, saan po, anong lugar, anong phone number, dedicated.
Okay, so we are located sa 72 Gary Martin Drive here in Bedford. We're just in front of BMO Center.
Yes, BMO Center.
Yes,
come visit. You can check our Facebook page, Instagram page as well, Kinapi Halifax. And yeah, you can give us a call. We have, yeah, our phone number here is 902-832-1866. And just in case you have cakes or breads to get, you want to order, you can give us a call
right away.
So, yun. Open po kami daily except Tuesdays. Even holidays.
Tuesday is rest day. No, Tuesday, yes. Ano yun na yan? Pahinga yan, pahinga. But anyway, thank you very much, Sandy and Sharon, for inspiring us, especially sa akin. Thank you very much. And of course, all our cast are watching right now. Maraming salamat. It's truly inspiring story. Cups, amazing story. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Cups. You're always welcome. And for you guys out there, you're always welcome to Tinape. Come visit us.
Anywhere in Atlantic, visit us.
All right. Thank you very much.
Bye. Thank you.